Well guys, I've got a dishwasher here. It's an Electrolux. It's the Dishlex Electrolux, and it is, I don't know if you can see that, it is a DX302. It has a self-heating element to heat up the water, and a common problem with these is they basically stop heating the water, so you only get cold water unless you run hot water through it, through your hot water system. So I'm going to show you how to fix, easy fix, one of these without calling in a dishwasher technician, which would probably cost you a couple hundred dollars. This will cost you a little bit of your time. You might have to buy, you will need a soldering iron and a screwdriver. So if you have to go and buy a soldering iron, it'll cost you about $20-$30 to fix it. So stay tuned and we'll get this done.
First thing we need to do is basically pull out the control panel. So we want to disconnect the power from the dishwasher, make sure no one gets electrocuted. As you can see, power is off, nothing's going on there, so we're all set to go. First thing we need to do is undo these screws. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 screws. Basically, that allows us to pull this front fascia off and get to this panel in here that we need to fix. Okay, now that we have all these screws out, simply just peel that forward and lift it up. Basically, what we have here is a few wires. This is the power, main power wire, and these wires are to the control panel, which we need to get out. So basically, easiest thing to do, disconnect these power wires, disconnect this wire, and then we can take this whole panel out. Okay, we have the panel off. Basically, what we need to do is pull this off of here. It's fairly simple to do. There's some little clips in here and here, and also here and here. Just simply get in behind them, push them in, and it just pops straight out. I've got the solder iron already plugged in. This is a quite good little tool. It's just basically a soldering iron holder that you can rest your soldering iron on without burning anything. Okay. Now this is the panel. And again, we need to open this up to get to the circuitry board. So on the side, there's a couple little clips. If you lift them up, and it opens up like this. Very simple. Okay, now that we have this open, there's two circuit boards. What we need to concentrate on is this bottom circuit board. In the corner here, there's a little black box. This is a relay, which turns the heating element on in the dishwasher. Now the connections on this relay to the circuit board are generally faulty. It's a common problem with these dishwashers. And the simplest thing to do is resolder these connections, which I'll show you how to do now. What we want to do is just pop the circuit board out. So we just lift it up and flip it over. Okay, so as you can see, there's the relay, and the connections are simply on this side. Okay, what we have is five connections we need to resolder to ensure that this relay works properly. So we have one there, one there, one there, one there, and one there. And basically, they, if you look from this side, it's any connection that is directly below the actual relay, which is this black box here. Okay, so now that our soldering iron is nice and hot, basically you just want to heat each of these up and re-melt the connection and the solder. Don't have to put too much heat into it, just enough to heat it up and reconnect the solder to the little wire that pokes through from the actual relay. And basically, it's as simple as that. It's an easy fix that you can do at home. Save yourself a couple hundred dollars by employing a by hiring a dishwasher technician. They charge you a $60 call out fee. They probably charge you for a new circuit panel. And then another call out fee to put it in after they ordered the part. So yeah, it's as simple as that. Okay, now that we have it all back together, we simply have to just reattach this back onto the dishwasher, connect all the wires back in, and we're right to go. If you like this video, please give it a like. And stay tuned for more to come. Thank you.